Dear folks, welcome to the group discussion here. Today's topic is education. Education. Is it Western education is good or Eastern education is good? Indian education system is good or foreign education system is good? See, earlier days, what is education? We had great university, Nalanda University, Benaras University, where we produced a lot of scholars, astronomy, astrology, psychology, philosophy. So Indians are very scholastic. But now you see where our education system is. Is it not only in India? In India, the education system is heart-oriented education. The moral science, the philosophy, the Gurukul systems we had in India. But in Western countries, what type of education? It is highly materialistic oriented, mind-oriented education. How to develop the mind? People to be scientists, to people to be doctors, engineers. The society needs what type of people? People who can contribute to the society. So education system is formed like that. Best engineers serving the government, best doctors serving the society. Society respects people who are better drilled and trained in the mind. India, we had art-oriented education, mind-oriented education. The moral science, it's the heart-oriented education. Artistic learning, it is heart-oriented education. The dedication towards the staff, the master, the teacher, the guru, it's something exceptional in India. It is said that mother, father, master and the god, this is the hierarchy of the respect we had in the society. Teachers are given high respect. But education system now, where it is going? Prayer is supposed to be heartfelt meditation. Even prayer we are unable to do. To do prayer is something greatest task. You go to temple, you put petitions, you cannot pray because there is no heart-to-heart relations. Even prayer, it is impossible for the people to do that. No heart. Heartless people, this is what our education system is producing. What is the difference between Indian education system and Western education system? Which is better? Which is good? What way we are inferior and what way they are superior? My dear youngsters, most of you are graduates, engineers, professionals. Take part in this discussion. Contribute your points. Forget about that you are taking part for some purpose. But involve yourself without expecting anything, whether you are getting a score or not. You are just contributing. You are being yourself. You are just speaking. You become the topic of yourself. So here, what do you like to take? Western or Indian education system? This particular group and share one other group.
Western
educational system is good. That is European, American educational system is good. You are comfortable with the Indian educational system? Yes, Indian educational system, they are comfortable. Now I leave this to the floor. Take part in this great discussion. Each one should stand up and speak. Those of them who are speaking, stand up and speak. Stand up.
Good morning, my colleagues. Today we are speaking about foreign education and Indian education. According to me, foreign education is better than Indian education. In foreign, they are practically 70% and theoretical 30%. In India, we are not practically. We are 70% in theory and only 30% we are in practical. In foreign, they are providing industrial exposure, when they are studying in second year or first year, they are going for industrial exposure. There, they will get the knowledge about the industry, and they can talk with the people who are working in the industry. So from there, they can get the information and basic knowledge about the industry. And but in India we can't get that.
Good evening. Actually, we are going to talk about the Indian education. So, as you know, we are the oldest civilization in the world, one of the oldest civilizations in the world, and our education systems have started before thousands of years. Narada University is the first university in India. Almost we are having some old educational systems. We are the first insisting the Gurukul systems. There the disciples go to the Guru house and learn all the thing which his Guru knows. That's an we study in the epics. It's based on the fully talented, and they not only they know the techniques and techniques and the science, they know about the Vedas. It's a heart oriented one. They taught about the Vedas, yogas, and a lot of the disciplines and all the things. Rather than technology, they taught the lifestyle also.
Okay, as you told, I'm agreed. But the way of teaching in India is I'm not appreciate about that. The professor in teaching not about like e-learning, but in foreign we can professor are teaching like if they are providing e-learning facilities, and they are in India the timing and duration from morning to evening you have to study, but in foreign there is no rules and regulations. So what about say about this matter? So you.
That is all depending on the infrastructure available in their country. That is, that is already developed country, so that they are providing the infrastructure. Still, we are still in developing country. I still support the Indian education is better than the foreign education, because we respect the people, we respect the gurus, we respect the students, we respect the colleague, we respect everyone, we respect the people. There it's not like that. So the students want to study, they study. Otherwise, they will go and they will become a terrorist also. That is the how in the foreign students are behaving like that. The in the foreign students they can get a good weapon and go, they will shoot it in the college. That's not happening in the Indian system. The Indian students are still respecting the gurus and respecting the parents. And the Indian education system is better than the Western education system, because they are still mathematically wise, we are good, very good than the Western physical. Suppose taking the doctors, the foreign doctors, without seeing the book, they don't prescribe the medicine. If you go to Indian doctor, without seeing the book, by seeing the patients, they can diagnose the what is the problem itself. That is not happening in the foreign system. So without getting any proper means diagnosed or getting the test done, they don't prescribe anything over there.
Sorry, I'm not agree with you, but because in foreign doctor is more educated, because if suppose Yuvraj Singh, we hear about Yuvraj Singh, when he has cancer, then he went to USA for treatment. Why? Because there is no that type of talented doctor to treat Yuvraj. Okay, that's why he went there. So what does it mean? This means foreigner students is more intelligent, their education system is more higher than Indian. That's why whenever any disease means serious disease, we go to other country for treatment. And also they are in college, they relation between student and a teacher is like more friendly. Here we told any teacher we called as a sir, but there we use as a friendly taking name. That's why we told foreign education is more high, more higher than Indian education system.
Excuse me, what you are saying is very wrong. Doctors are very talented here only. Why we are going there means we need a facilities. Because of facilities only we are going there to take the treatments. Okay, in India we have less facilities to take treatment. So only we are. But compared to foreigners, here only the talented doctors are here. Okay, talented doctors are going for there to work for salaries, for income, for other things. But many of the talented doctors are only in here. They are educated by Indian only. Okay, Indian education only, not by.
Sorry, you told here more they are more facility. Why they are more facility?
They
are
very developed country, so they having facilities. So but education.
How they all develop? You know how? Because there is education system higher. That's why they develop more. Their way of thinking is higher. Compared to us.
But we are discussing about education. In education, here only the talented persons are there. Talented doctors are there. They are going to earn money only. But the talented persons are here only. Okay.
For your information, they are working under the foreigner. They are not
but
working.
The foreigners using the talent of Indian only, no?
They have a talent, but they don't have that much population there. They are using Indians to work. They're using Indians to work because they don't have that much population to work.
No, they have the money, okay? No, they are the leaders, okay? They need some people to work on from their hospitals. That's the reason we have our doctors going there, they're working over there. So all major surgeries are done by our Indian doctors only, not the foreign doctors. If you go and compare it, even for Yuvraj Singh also, I think that, so one of the Indian doctors might be involved in the...
Might be. It's
okay.
Not there.
Here for a Vajpayee knee replacement also, even Indian doctor only did it, okay, not the foreign doctor. So if you go and check, so all the Vajpayee, both knees are replaced by Indian doctor only. But he works in the USA, that's it.
But they were educated in foreign.
No, they are educated in India.
How you see?
In India.
You see big doctors and
MBBS
land.
They are going there, okay? For working only they are going. But educated by only Indians, okay?
Why, if our doctors have talent, why their talent are not appreciated here? What is the education system doing here?
That is because of lack of money in India, okay?
Yeah.
There is lack of money. There is lack of money, not for lack of the knowledge, okay? There is difference.
If knowledge is there, we should be.
There is a difference between lack of knowledge and lack of the money, okay? Still, we don't have. Still, we are in developing country.
We are more populated here. They are less populated. They are having more money. We have less money. So, we are more educated persons are going there to earn money only. But more educated peoples are in India only. By Indian education only, we are more. Compared to Western education, Indian education is best.
Then why most of the students are going abroad for education?
Rare only, not most.
In fact, the record says 50% of students
for infrastructure, facilities,
that's
for
only
they're going.
We are not having better facilities in India. Why we are not having? That is your point.
We don't have a facility, but we have a knowledge. Okay. What? So, we don't have facilities, but we have a knowledge. Okay.
What knowledge we are having? With knowledge, should be create a facility.
There is a difference between facility and knowledge, okay? Facilities
is
provided by the government. So, still we are in doubt, still we have a lack of money. We don't have that much facilities. That's the reason people are going over there and getting the money over
then
there.
Then when we will get facilities? Then what we are educated?
Still developing. India is now still developing.
Then when will develop? Further education system to develop.
For information, you know, in the US universities, most of the professors are Indians. Purely, they're Indians.
Then so Indians have no.
No, we are not. We have
why Indian professors are not educating here, our students? Why? They're going there. Because our education is not good. That is not.
Not like that. You know, we are developing country. We are the basic of our occupation is agriculture till the last decade. Okay. But most of the we are depending upon agriculture. So we are not technologically not sound like the Western countries. So now we are developing the aids, teaching aids and teaching systems are now we are developing. So be, due to the infrastructure only they went then settled there. Okay, now we are also coming ahead. Our IIT is a number one institute in the world, one of the most I strongly disagree because most of the IIT students are masters in a lot of the technologies. In UC, NASA, Microsoft, you see all the universities in US, German, all they are working is a very, very good position.
I agree with your point, but Swami Dayanand has written value of values. In India, we are given the value to the money, but in foreign, they are giving the value towards the work. What you are working, that is a good thing. But we are more value giving to the money. That's it.
No, not like that. Money, we don't. That's another topic. Actually,
no, it is related to the this topic.
No.
Because you said already, Indian peoples are going to over there for the money.
Money. They need some good infrastructure. But the American industries want Indians to come and teach.
But they are.
They respect not. They respect only with the knowledge here. No, they have well, very good infrastructures and things, but they didn't have the highly technical and well-versed professors. So they appoint Indians. You know, in Microsoft, most of the products are successfully done by the Indians. In Google, that one Indian is CEO of Google. So now,
why they are not come back to India? Why they are settle our life in foreign?
Yes, because they're...
they are going for only
yes,
to...
Everybody working for money. You are working for money. You are studying means you are working for money. If you got the job in Embed, you said, no, I don't work
in... What is the value of education?
No, value of education, you study here and go settle there. Okay, you know the value of education.
Everything
most
is
of,
menu, money.
Huh?
Everything is money.
No, it's not depending on money, depending on knowledge. If you have well
if,
knowledge...
If for, Western boys are... want to develop our country, why the Indians are going to there and develop ourselves?
No, not like that.
Since they don't have knowledge, they are using our knowledge. Okay, that's the reason we are going there. We are sharing our knowledge to the US.
Why they are sharing the knowledge in the foreign? In why not in India?
Since we don't have those many facilities in India, the government is not able to support those facilities to Indians. Okay, when people are going over there. Okay, if the, all the Indians over in the US if come over to India, if the government is ready to support to those Indians, they'll definitely they will come back. So, but now the government is not ready to give the support to those Indians. That's the reason people are going there and they're working over there. Okay.
According to my knowledge, Indians are providing all these facilities. If you see, 80% of a franchise.
If the case, why so much unemployment in India? So we are...
Unemployment is not there.
Who said unemployment is not there?
We
there
are not fit for the frame, that's
not,
why unemployment
like
is
frame,
there.
Okay. We have unemployment because of we don't have provided those many facilities in the people.
For
Indians.
You, I want to say one thing. If you go to SSB, CDS, Combined Defense Force, there 10,000 vacancy are there. Okay. In a year, 2 terms are there. First terms, more than 1,000 students are appear over there. But they are taking only 10 people. Why? They are fit for their job. Unemployment is not there. Because company don't want to take losers. They always want to best part of the country.
No, no. Not the company not ready to take the losers. Here, our population is above 100 million. But not in the case like that. Okay, that's not, you know, if you're talking about defense, okay, you know, Indian defense is one of the most talented and skilled in US Air Force and Navy. They have the team, but only the team, the SEAL team is having to handle all the situations, but not like the, without the modern aids and modern equipments and radar systems, they didn't survive. But it's not like our Indian, we have skill. We have knowledge. Our system also, though we are not more technically sound, but we are improving, our technical knowledge is very good when compared to others.
But 80% they are using foreign techniques, foreign equipments.
No. Now they are...
Russia is given 80% of aircraft to the Indian.
Yes, because we have enough money to set up the manufacturing plant in India. But there in MiG, you know, MiG now it's Indianized. We have working on some UAV and Lakshya, all the things. You know, Agni, we have some technologies, not like that. We are improving. Now DRDO is now working on a lot of projects, you know. World's first underground sonar fighting system. We are having. Not simply blind it all. Due to the financial only, we are like, always we are very good in sound and knowledge. Nobody can agree. In IQ level also, we are number two. First is Israel and second is India.
Might be we are going to different way because our topic is education system. Then I want to say, if our education system is good, then why IIT is India number one education institute? But they are not in global rank, in 100, not top 20s, they are out of 20, out of 100, sorry, my friends told out of 100. Why net not coming within 100?
Indians are both hardworking people, they are smart working, so they were used by India hard work.
If you are hardworking, you will already top. You have to top on the top.
Because we are having this lack of facilities in here.
Facilities? Why? My question is why you have lower
population is lack.
Population. You know why population is increasing our India? Because of less education system.
No,
our education system is less.
That's why education system. But we are having a lack of facilities. That's what the reason.
No, but the number of seats in IITJ for a particular engineering branch is constant, not 60. Only 60 in each branch. So their responsibility is this, to take part in inventions, new ideas, new technology developments. Then why the IITians did not achieve this? Any technical invention they did last 10 years, last 20 years, what they did in the field of technical invention? IITians, our best technical mind.
No, actually, last year they worked together with ISRO. They made a satellite also for research. They are doing lot of things, lot of projects.
Which satellite? Can you elaborate?
Yeah, America did that before.
No, main thing is the finance. Again, we are insisting the same. We are not having the finance to even the survival. How do we get the finance for research?
No, our every IIT get the funds from the government. Government provides enough funds for it.
No, it's not enough. Because of, if you compare to the US, but its fund is very low.
What is the problem? We are always comparing to the US. What kind of fund US is getting? We are not getting crores of money, but we are simply 1 crore or 50 lakh. Within 50 lakh, we can do something. IITians can do something if they are IITians within 50 lakh.
But they simply understand. That's a developed country. We are still under. We have a lot of items to develop. Not only in research and development, we are very lagging. We can't give the chance to everybody. Okay, few of them must get the chance and they are surviving. But we are an underdeveloped country like China. We have that's the only thing. If we have the same infrastructures and same funding, we will be the number one. But now we are doing this.
What happens with Japan? What happens with Japan after two atomic bomb attacks? And they have completely destroyed their infrastructure, their everything they have lost. But within 20 or 50 years, now they are where? You are talking always about the infrastructure. We don't have enough funds, we don't have infrastructure. But Japan, that time they don't have
enough infrastructure, enough funds, but still they are managed to become the number one in technologies.
One of the number one
one of the best in technologies. You cannot say the number one of the number one. Because
of less population, they are increasing the technologies now.
That's what I am saying. Less population, and how can you
less population, large amount of money. That's why.
Yeah, good. Less population, and it is also a part of education system. So India's education system is not up to the mark. If you teach a lady to just control the population, so you say part of education, na? Control the population.
Now we are controlling the population, no? But before we didn't.
Yeah, now.
We are doing now, okay? But in Japan, they are more, they having money, but less population. They are already educated, so they are able to increase their education. But here, the population is more, money is less. So how can we able to educate the person? So educated person also, they are going to abroad. How can you said the IT field are not able to do the work because of if they give money also they can't able to do because their educated persons are going abroad. How can they able to improve the field? They never improve because of the lacking many of lack of the things.
I want to ask you a question. Tell me any one field related to education, the Indian education is better than foreign any field.
I like to say that medicine field is better.
Medicine field also foreign is good.
Medicine field, they say the IT field, everything is software managed.
All software India buy from foreigner. In India, no develop any software itself.
India buy first. India is not bought from foreigner. Okay, we developed it. Okay, we went over there. We developed it. Okay, not the, we didn't buy from there. Okay,
it's already made by them. We just work under them.
It's not only made by them. It's a group. Okay, a group. We are the part of that group. Okay, it's not only
but
for one foreigner.
The head of
not
the
only
group.
One foreigner made this one. Okay, no. All together. In the all, we are the part of it.
See, we are not innovative. We are not innovative. We just took them product and we are just producing.
No, not like that.
See, we have enough money. See, if you see each and every political person have enough money. They have enough land, they have a good car imported. If you see Karunanidhi, he is having Hummer, he is having Lamborghini, which costs around 1 crore something. So we have enough money, but people don't want to do all these things.
People
want only education. After education, they don't want to do any social work. Those are highly educated, IIT only. They don't want to work for India. They after completing IIT, they want to earn money more. So that's why they are going to foreign. But only foreign they will get good money. Then they only for money purpose they are going.
Not only for money purpose.
They are going.
Still there are a lot of companies in India,
Why they are not working in India for?
Why? Some people are working in India, some person are going for abroad, but most of the person working for India.
Out of 100, 70% are going to abroad. The 30% they are not having good opportunity to do something. They are not innovative.
No, not like that. In Indian industries, we have a lot of talenters in Indian industries. Ratan Tata.
He's a foreigner, yes.
Even Sonia is a foreigner. I don't know that.
If you go all the companies or any big organization, all CEO, you can find the most of the all CEO from foreigner.
No.
I don't agree with
only
you.
Few company.
Not only few company.
Only few
so
company.
We are not talented. Why so many projects are coming from US or from abroad? How many so many company IT companies are in are in India? If you compare to Chennai, Bangalore, or Hyderabad, we have so many n number of companies, IT companies. We are still getting the projects in US only. So why we are getting? If you don't have analogy, why you are getting the projects?
No. See, we are working. We are not a CEO or we are not managing. We are working under the foreigner. We have knowledge, then why we are not your...
Foreigners are one or two, but...
Foreigner, what no, not two? They are handling us.
They are just managing, okay? They are managing.
What is the managing? They have a good knowledge, that's why they are managing us.
For managing the team, no need for technical skills, okay?
Who told?
See,
all decision taken by manager.
Decision taken by manager.
That all decision.
Manager,
all.
Management is different, technical is different, okay?
No,
we are technical experts. We are technical
experts. They work as a...
They are only managing the team, the expert, okay?
They work as a team leader, and after they having good knowledge, then they will become a manager.
No. The management is different, technical is different.
No. It's
in
not,
any company...
Without technical, you can't become a manager.
Any company, there will be two paths. Okay, one is management side, one is for technical side. Technical side, if you go there is technical leader, technical architect, technical manager.
Technical leader, who is the technical leader?
All the technical leaders are by Indian also only, not the foreigners.
No. Tell me the name.
Check it to all the companies.
Check it with Pro,
Premji.
Oh. Only few.
Oh, check it Infosys. Check it Satyam. Whatever it may be.
Tell me the name, na.
I got it right. Check it all the companies.
Only few.
Oh,
I'm
not
only
few. 90% are Indians. 90% are Indian. 10% are from OLS. Okay. Check it all over in India. Go and find out.
And why you are not taking money from them for education?
Why you are not taking
money from them?
For
education.
Why should you get it?
Huh?
Why should you get money from them? So they are not...
They are having enough money, na.
Okay.
So you can approach from them.
No, if you have money, will you give money, donate to money to orphans? No, right?
Yeah, I'll give. If I want to improve my India,
okay.
I'll give.
So, then how much percentage of donate to money to orphans?
Means I can't understand.
No, how much percent of, money...
See, Ratan Tata, he is giving his salary, 70% salary for... Society for developing, he's having colleges, he's having schools.
Correct.
He's having research schools.
Okay, where? In India or abroad?
In India.
So that means?
In India and abroad, he's a foreigner.
Whatever it may be, whoever it may be. But why not he's not developing in a foreigner? Since we have skilled people in India, okay, he is investing his money in India because he can get the more knowledge people, skilled people in India. That's the reason every foreigner, even for Bill Gates, also investing money in India only. Okay.
No, it's market, man. It's market.
It's not only market. Okay. We have so talented, so skilled persons in India. Since they have lack of money, they are not able to grow it. That's the only. Only for money reason we are not able to grow, okay?
In foreign, they can't do labor, get labor. Because they are highly educated and they don't do like simple things, suppose lifting the sand. But here, there are lots of people who can do it. Because their mind is, Ratan Tata is highly technical person. That's why they planted here his company. Because they get here more people for labor, as a labor, but they can't got...
No.
This is not skill, this is not technology.
It's not like in India we have labors, but in Western countries we don't have labors. They are also, for every job you have to need such designations. So if Westerns, all they are not the managers. Huh?
Okay, one question I am asking to you. Suppose a foreigner comes to India and they recruit the good quality of student and they take them, but why not India going to abroad and they selecting good people and they selecting good foreigner and they give a high salary to pay and they get knowledge?
No, already we have a lot of talents in India. Why don't we go for abroad?
But why then India's great people and lot of knowledge people are going to foreign?
Yes, You told a lot of knowledge people, for that only they are going.
You have excess knowledge, okay,
that's the reason. But still you are telling developing.
Yes, people are knowledgeable, but countries under developing. You know, now the lot of education systems are changing. But in the next 20 years, it will be India will be the most challenging for Western countries.
And you told money is not part of education. For education person, if suppose a person is highly educated, they won't go for money. He thinks about technical and he knows, he want to do something for innovation. But for money about, there is not for education.
Okay, my dear friends, please take your seat. We had a wonderful and a great discussion, group discussion. Education system, foreign education system are better compared to Indian education system. My dear friends, first you should understand, in this globalized world, each country is opening up its economy. Each country is opening up its boundary. The boundaries are getting slowly demolished or erased. For example, in manufacturing sector, India has allowed foreign companies to come in. In pharmaceuticals, we have allowed. But in education, we have not yet allowed. In newspapers and magazines, we have not yet allowed. In firms, law firms, we have not allowed. So some of the sectors we have not yet allowed. If foreign university comes to India, it's going to come. They're going to pass the bill. Almost all the parties have agreed. And once if it is passed, then Harvard will be coming here. One, Cambridge will be coming here. What not? So all the universities will be coming to India. And we'll be learning directly what they are. And the real competition will be here in India. Indian universities versus foreign universities. You can see directly foreigners coming here, they'll be training and teaching, and already established, well reputed institutions in India will be equally fighting with them. But they have a brand, it's a globalized brand, as some of you had an argument discussion. IIT, where does it stand? Of course, it stands somewhere around 50 or 60 the rank according to the position. It comes to 50 or 60, it doesn't come in the first 10 also. But IITians are recruited by foreign firms, very much in demand, that we can find. The students, of course, they are very talented, but the infrastructure, the problems are there. Now coming here, highly philosophical, if you go, which education system is better? See, all the child are same, whether it is American or Indian, British child, everybody are same. First you take care of the basic need, food, stomach. When you have food, problem is solved. Almost 90% problem is solved. Then you teach. All the child are capable, equally capable. Only thing you have to provide, nice environment, infrastructure, the food, the facilities. Then almost you don't find any discrimination between and that. See here, all the mothers are same, whether British mother or American mother. All the lovers are same. The feelings and attitude and the inner feelings, everything same. The learning, the hunger for learning, it's also same. Only thing, right motivation. So the basic thing should be taken care of, food, where they are much comfortable than us. Materialistically, they have all the facilities. Once you take care of the basic needs, then education, people will be getting highly involved in education. It's good that in Tamil Nadu, where we are living, we have midday noon meal scheme, where even varieties of food is given, 20 different varieties of food is given. So once food is taken care of, the mind starts functioning in a better way, and the learning process starts. So let us concentrate in our Indian system, education system, on for the basic needs, which the majority of people need, say from the remote village to the city.